Hey, what's up, studs? Ryan here, or M&R Productions, and welcome to my comparison of the three LEGO Star Wars droid gunship sets. If you guys do enjoy the video, I'd like to remind you to please leave a like down below, and if you're new to the channel, subscribe so you'll see more of my future LEGO videos. Today, I will be using my newer remodeled system for comparing LEGO sets, and in this system, there are five separate categories: minifigures, playability, design, value, and M&R opinion. For each category, sets will be awarded points based on which one is the best, which one is the second best, and which one is the worst. The best getting the most points, the second best getting the middle amount of points, and the worst getting the lowest tier of points you can earn in a category. At the end, the tally will be totaled up, and it will determine which set is the best, oh so arbitrarily. Anyway, without further ado, let's go ahead and start talking about some of the information about each set. Our first droid gunship over here on the left is set 7678, released in 2008 for $30. That's about $35 in today's money. It included three minifigures there, two battle droids that had double straight arms, and one battle droid with two curved arms, and a grand total of 329 pieces, so not a bad price per piece either. Overall, the design at the time felt like a pretty large set and wasn't bad for $30. Come 2014, we saw the 75042 droid gunship for $50. That's about $53 in 2018 money, so not a big change. Four minifigures being a battle droid, a Kashyyyk trooper, Chewbacca, and a super battle droid, 439 pieces to complete the model. And most recently, and perhaps most controversially, the 75233 droid gunship, released in 2019 for $50, no adjustment for inflation needed, obviously. It included four minifigures, or does include Yoda, Chief Tarful, and two Kashyyyk battle droids, which are very, very nice, and we have 389 pieces, so the price per piece getting worse with each model release. Now, obviously, price per piece does not translate directly to the value, but we'll get to that in the value section of this set. So let's start out with which set has the best minifigures. 2014 model brought us just three straight up battle droids, nothing crazy, nothing new at the time, just three regular old battle droids. Now, I can't say anything really bad about that. There's nothing wrong with just including battle droids, but LEGO didn't really try to go the extra mile as far as figures in that set. So not a knock, but also not all that great as far as figures go. 2014 brought us a little bit more variety. We got a battle droid and a beautiful Kashyyyk trooper there. We also got the beautiful Chewbacca and a very nice super battle droid. So a lot more variety in 2014. And it really just depends on what you want out of your set, whether you like the variety or not. Personally, I typically like to lean towards having all the figures be from one side. So like having Kashyyyk trooper and Chewbacca probably not, doesn't go well with the droid gunship, but it does add playability where you can have the figures fight the ship, which is nice. So it just kind of depends on the way you look at it. And then over here with the newest droid gunship, we have two Kashyyyk troopers. Look very cool. Obviously, got those new prints on there for 2019. And then we have Chief Tarful, who is an excellent figure as well. Very similar to Chewbacca, obviously, just with a little bit of extra armor and padding and whatever. And then, of course, Yoda there with a beautiful little green lightsaber. So can't go wrong with these figures. So which figures are the best? In my opinion, the 2019 version has the best minifigure selection. The second best minifigure selection is going to go to the 2014 droid gunship. And the worst minifigures, in my opinion, is in the 2008 droid gunship. They just didn't try to go out of the box there, and sometimes I feel like that works and sometimes I feel like it doesn't, and in this case I really like what they were able to offer with the two newer models and not so much with the older model. So as far as playability goes, the 2008 version has some limited features, the first of which would be the cockpit up here, where you can actually place a battle droid in there to pilot the ship. There is nothing really for him to connect into. He just kind of lays in there, which isn't bad, but it's also not that great. But that's how he fits in. That's the playability of that. It's a very swooshable set, so you can kind of swoosh it around. It's not going to fall apart, which is nice, unless you, of course, bang it into the table. But anyway, the turrets up front kind of have all this articulation, and there's not much else to it. You can also move whatever these like teeth things are, but nothing crazy up there. The main feature of this set, I guess you have landing gear as well, right? You can move that up and down. But the main feature of the set is going to be the bomb dropper found underneath. You can see they have these different types of bombs here, and it works with a little rubber band and a little spinny thing. And all you have to do is spin this thing on top. You just take it, and as you're flying, you can just spin it, and they drop all the bombs just like that. So that's the main feature, or really the only feature of the set for the 2008 model, and it's not a bad one. You can do some nice bombing runs with the droid gunship, but that's all it really does, so nothing too great. bringing the 2014 model into frame here, you'll find it has some very similar features. The first of which is the cockpit up here. You have all these rotatable pieces and the teeth can move again, so nothing different really from the 2008 version. However, underneath, inside the cockpit where you can put the minifigure, or the Valedroid to be more specific if you so choose, will just again just kind of fit in there and lays inside. But there is a control panel, or like a little, I want to dump him out, heads up display in there that looks just like that with the ATAP on there. So that's actually really, really cool. I actually didn't notice that until like a minute ago when I was playing around with this just to make sure I kind of knew everything about it. And I was like, oh, that's a thing. So that's a really nice little additional touch to this set that I hadn't noticed really. The other thing it has that the other set doesn't have though are these spring-loaded shooters on the side. Those are really nice features, and basically you just press in on them and yeah, just like that. Great feature. All right, you just press in on it and it'll shoot off. So just like that, the spring-loaded missiles are actually really nice that LEGO's brought those in. They actually started out in 2014 with this wave of sets, and you'll find it on both sides. So pretty easy to do, just like that. Very strong and powerful. So I do give those props. Now, the other feature of the set, obviously, of the landing gear underneath, which can fold up much nicer than the other one, but that's really overall design type thing. The bombs underneath, once again, very similar design, three bombs on each side. They have much nicer look to them, but that's neither here nor there. The way to drop them off from underneath is to pull back on these. So you just pull back and down they drop. We pull the other one on the right, down they drop. It can be a little finicky sometimes, I find, but it seems like it just worked just well enough there. No issues at all. You can see kind of how that mechanism works from underneath there. Just pretty simple, straightforward. To load them back in is pretty easy. You probably want to have the landing gear up to do this. Just gives you a little bit of extra space, but you just do one at a time on each of the rods in there on the interior of the droid gunship. So no additional play features on the 2014 model, just pretty much the same stuff plus those spring-loaded shooters, which will give it probably a little bit of a nod over the 2008 model when we do the rankings. Let's swing over the newest model and see if LEGO added anything worthwhile. The 2019 model does not bring us much new in terms of playability. You do have the same kind of movable turrets up front. Everything kind of moves the same way. You can pull up the cockpit and place one of your Kashyyyk battle droids this time right on down in there. There is no control printed or sticker panel in there. It's just a much simpler design for the interior, which there's nothing wrong with. I never even really noticed the other ones, so what's the difference really? But you also have some stud shooters on the side here. So those work just like the stud shooters on minifigures. You take them, you push down on the part, and they shoot off. So pretty straightforward. You guys should know how stud shooters work if you're watching this video. You're a pretty big fan of LEGO Star Wars, I'm sure you know. The big difference here, though, is going to be found underneath. Of course, you have this landing gear. Once again, I feel like every time I've been like, underneath you have the turret, the missiles, but first you have landing gear. But yes, landing gear is important. It helps all of these sets have a nice posture to them when they are landed, so I do appreciate the landing gear on all of these. But you have some flick fire missiles on the bottom side of this set instead of the bombs that drop out. So you can shoot them two at a time. They go off in pairs, so there's no way to shoot them off one at a time. You just pair, or you could shoot them all eight or all four at a time or six at a time, just however you want to kind of divvy it up. But the way to do that, all you have to do is push in on these just like that. You can get some pretty good distance on them if you push them like really fast, like that, they went pretty far. But if you just kind of do it pretty wimpy, they'll just kind of fall. But they do work really well. I really actually like the flickfire missiles on this set, because they're not really flickfire missiles if you're not flicking them, right? They're just more of missiles. And I do appreciate that a lot better than having to manually flick them. I think they work a lot better with a system like this. I think it's an excellent system for this particular droid gunship. As far as my playability rankings go, my highest ranking is going to go to the 2014 model in the middle there. The second highest ranking, so 2 points to the 2019 model, and just one lowly point to the 2008 model, which its only feature is going to be those bombs dropping. The other two droid gunships do have stud shooters or the spring-loaded missile there on the side. The 2008 model does not offer any additional feature, and that really puts it miles behind. So moving on to the design category, this is a tough one because all of these kind of have their own unique design, but I think honestly, and this is a really tough one for me, but I think the best design is the 2019 version. As much as I like the size of the 2019 2014 version, I love the accuracy that they were able to bring to the new 2019 version. The blue color just kind of blends in a lot better than it did on the older version, which just has much sharper cuts from one color to the other than this one does, especially with the use of these curved pieces here. Really helps that blue, which this one does not have. So the 2019 version, in my opinion, has the best design. It also has a very solid design. Like, the size is nice. It's smaller than I would wish, but the size is still nice, and it just overall looks the best. The 2014 and the 2008 version are pretty much, I mean, it's pretty obvious which one's better. The 2014 version has to get the nod here. It just has better pieces than the older one does. It has better features. It's much more well built, much more well put together. Just got everything. Just it's a more complete model. That's what it really is. Of course, the sticker designs also really help it. You have a much more detailed pieces. You have much more detailed stickers on the newer one than the older one, which also help it out there. So the 2014 version is going to get 2 points there, and the 2008 version, once again, with just 1 point. On to the topic of value, which is a tough question because a lot of people see value differently, whether a set has good minifigures or whether a set has a good price per piece. But in my opinion, I think the best value of any of these sets is going to be the 2008 version. $30 for that thing was a really, really good price. Seeing it jump to $50 in 2014 really kind of sucked, and it's still $50 in 2019 for a model that's just as big as what we got in 2008. And obviously things change, there's new pieces, inflation, new minifigures, like it all kind of goes into it, but $30 is a really good price for that 2008 set. The second best value, in my opinion, has to go to the 2014 version. $50 for 439 pieces and four pretty solid minifigures is a pretty darn good deal. No real complaints there on the price. My biggest offender here, though, for price is going to be the 2019 version. $50 for 389 pieces and four, once again, not bad minifigures, but the price per piece is a killer there, and it's a smaller model. It just doesn't really shape up well for the 2019 version in the value category. My opinion is that the 2008 has the best value, 2014 has the second best value, and 2019 has the worst value of any of these sets. Don't forget, you guys can vote on the poll that is on the screen right now, which will help decide what the fan favorite droid gunship is. Our last category is M&R opinion, and I think on any given Sunday, any of these could win. Like, it's really tough for me to pick a winner here. The 2019 version has a beautiful new design. It's a really clean look as far as the colors go. Obviously, it's smaller than I would like, but for what it looks like, it looks really good. It's just a little overpriced. The 2014 version presents a great value. It's a large model, which I particularly like, but the colors are a little off. And then, of course, the 2008 model was really cheap. It's got the nostalgia factor for me, and it just still looks the part. It doesn't look that much worse than any of the others, and it's really hard for me to pick a favorite here. In fact, I'm going to have to call it a draw. I can't pick one over the other. If I had to keep one of these, I wouldn't be able to pick one. I just wouldn't. If I really had to pick one to keep, I really couldn't pick one over the other. I think they're all three just excellent droid gunships. Of course, each has their flaws, and for that reason, I can't put one over the other. So we're going to call it a draw on the M&R opinion for the first time ever. We now have our final tally for which set is going to be the best. In last place, we have the 2008 droid gunship with just 7 points. Not a bad showing, but also not a great showing. In second place, we have the 2014 gunship, which earned 10 points throughout the process. Not a bad showing either. But in first place, well, not really first place actually, because it also has 10 points. They tied. The 2014 and 2019 droid gunships are a draw as well. And that does go well with what I was just saying a minute ago on the M&R opinion part, where I can't really pick one over the other. I do recognize that this one did get put down a little bit farther, thanks to it having not as good minifigures, playability, or design, but that cheap price and the value for it really does help when I'm just kind of looking at it. But the cheap price slash value and the nostalgia factor for that model for me really makes it a even draw. And obviously this one just not as good overall on the actual, like, looking at the facts. But as far as I can tell, these two seem like they're going to be a tie for me. I couldn't pick one over the other. There's the scoreboard. Anyway, if you guys have an opinion on these, you can vote on the poll on the top right of your screen, and you can vote for which droid gunship is the best. If you haven't been following along the whole video, that's 2008, 2014, and 2019. Let me know in the comments section below what you guys thought of the video, or if you guys have any thoughts on these droid gunships. I think they're all good models. They all have pros and cons, just like anything. Let me know in the comment section below what you guys think of these droid gunships and if you would have changed my rankings in this video. That's all I have for you guys today. If you want to check out more comparison videos, you'll see one on the end screen here in a second. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. And if you did enjoy, please leave a like. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.